Let's look at the character of Pip. Now, Pip, in Great Expectations, goes from being a young poor boy in the countryside to being a wealthy young gentleman in London. He transitions very dramatically throughout the story. Remember, Great Expectations is what we would term a Bildungsroman. A Bildungsroman is essentially a genre of novel or story where we follow the main protagonist from childhood and as they develop and transition into teenage years and through adulthood and all the lessons they learn throughout this period. Now, remember in Great Expectations, Pip is the protagonist. We find him as a young poor boy in the countryside in Kent. He works for Miss Havisham under Joe Gargery. Okay, that's his uncle, basically his sister's husband. He falls for Estella. However, we find that this naivety both drives him to want to self-educate and ultimately become a gentleman so that he becomes worthy of what he sees as her love, because remember that she is part of upper class society and he is working class. Separately, however, he mistakenly believes Magwitch, who was the convict initially at the start of the story, he judges his appearance and believes that he is somebody of very disreputable background. Of course, he is a convict, but later on when Pip does get an inheritance, he then moves to London, he moves in high society, he is horrified to learn that this inheritance comes from a contaminated source because it's Magwitch who has worked really hard in order to ensure that Pip has an easy life. Now, when it comes to writing about his character or even writing about Great Expectations generally and its key themes, for example, love, family and so on, you do need to become really well versed in understanding Pip's character. Therefore, I have selected a few quotations which you could use when discussing the character of Pip, either for your coursework or exams, as well as the word level analysis to do for each quotation. So let's go over them. Now, the first quote which I would suggest if you're considering and writing about Pip's character is when he states, "What I dreaded was ellipses. I, being at my grimiest and commonest, should lift up my eyes and see Estella looking in." Now here, this is when Pip is working for Miss Havisham. He's very self-conscious. He feels really unworthy of Estella. He's fallen for her. However, he is so self-conscious. And of course, in this quotation, we can see this massive divide in terms of society and in terms of the class that Pip occupies. So he's working in Miss Havisham's farm, whilst Estella occupies an upper class position in society. Even, for example, the depiction of him looking up whilst Estella is looking down at him. Of course, this is a very clear indicator of the vast difference in their social group and their social class. Now, here we can see that Pip really feels very unworthy of Estella. He feels unworthy of her love, and he also is very embarrassed of his working class roots. The word level analysis you want to do when you're illustrating this, and of course this can be tied in especially to the theme of love, but also the theme of social class in Great Expectations, is firstly the repetition of the pronoun I, which shows just how self-conscious Pip is. And also the superlative adjectives grimiest and commonest. Again, these adjectives relate to Pip's social class and his social group, and he is embarrassed to be part of this. And of course, one of his avowed aims in this story is to become a gentleman who is worthy of Estella's affections. The second quotation when it comes to Pip's character is when he states, "I have neither the good sense nor the good feeling to know that this was all my fault, ellipsis. I felt impatient of him and out of temper with him." Now here, he is describing just how he quickly took Joe Gargery for granted. He also became really embarrassed of Joe. Part of his transition from his class was him also really looking down on all those who genuinely loved him, especially Joe Gargery. Now here we can see that Pip seems very regretful to realize that he became so embarrassed and also very annoyed with Joe Gargery, annoyed with almost Joe Gargery's simplicity, his simplistic style of living and his simplistic character and mannerisms. However, of course, we later learn that Pip regrets this heavily. Now, the word level analysis you want to do here is firstly the alliteration of the letter N in neither and nor. Also, the repetition of the word good to talk about Pip, how he feels really, really embarrassed and he looks back on how he looked down on Joe Gargery. However, Joe is one of the few people that genuinely cares and has affection for him. And also, finally, the repetition of the pronoun him. This is to talk about Joe, and this shows how Pip felt almost embarrassed and exasperated by him. The next quotation to bear in mind, the third quote relating to Pip's character, is when later on, after his move to London, he initially thinks that the fortune that he's gotten and he benefits from was from Miss Havisham. However, he encounters Magwitch, okay? So he encounters him much, much later on in the story, and he is horrified and appalled to realize that this fortune that he has comes from a very contaminated origin, which is Magwitch's murky dealings. Now, his horror at this, and his horror at even being associated with Magwitch and associated with the class of convicts that Magwitch comes from, is highlighted when he states, "The abhorrence in which I held the man, the dread I had of him, the repugnance with which I shrank from him," ellipsis. Now here, Dickens uses the rule of three to describe the horror, the shock, the disgust that Pip has with Magwitch. Here, you've got abhorrence, dread, and repugnance. So the rule of three here is effective in showing that Pip, even if he now realizes that he's a gentleman, he's wealthy as a result of this contaminated money from Magwitch, he still cannot reconcile himself with that. Of course, he later does. However, initially, he still holds on to these ideas that anything working class is to be looked down upon. However, anything upper class is something to be really reviled and to love. Now, the next quotation to bear in mind with Pip's character is when he later realizes that all the things that he saw as near dear to him, all the ideals that he strived for, such as Estella's love, all of these are very hollow ideals, and actually the people that genuinely loved him and cared for him were the people he grew up around, Biddy, his friend, as well as Joe. And he tries to go back and marry Biddy as well as reconcile with Joe. However, he realizes that things are very different. Joe and Biddy have actually fallen in love. Now, he states when he realizes this, "I would not have gone back to Joe now. I would not have gone back to Biddy now," ellipsis. "My sense of my own worthless conduct to them was greater than every consideration." So here, he realizes things are different. However, he also realizes that one of the reasons why Joe and Biddy have moved on is because they themselves were always very genuine. They were very honest to each other. However, it's Pip who had changed drastically, and now he feels really worthless. Of course, we can see that Pip, he has developed as a character. He's gone from being really naive, holding people who are upper class on a pedestal and assuming that just because they're upper class, they are more moral, they are good. Actually, he's learned that this is not the case. And he also learns that people who are working class, like Joe and Biddy, they are actually very good people. They were very good to him. However, he now feels really worthless. He doesn't feel worthy even of their forgiveness. Now, the word love analysis you want to do here is firstly the repetition of the phrase, "I would not have gone back." He repeats this twice to show just how emphatic he is in feeling unworthy of Joe and Biddy's forgiveness. Also, you want to focus on the repetition of the pronoun my to show that Pip feels really, really embarrassed, really horrified by his conduct. And finally, you want to discuss the comparative adjective greater than, okay? Here we can see that Pip feels really embarrassed of his past conduct. He wishes Joe and Biddy could even forgive him for how narrow-minded he was in buying into the idea that anything upper class is to be revered, whilst anything working class is to be looked down upon and to be shunned and neglected, because he did shun and neglect both Joe and Biddy. The final quotation for Pip's character is, this is when he had confessed his love for Estella, okay? This ties into the theme of love, and also this illustrates the unequal balance between Pip and Estella. Here, this is where in chapter 44, he confesses to her, "Still, I love you. I have loved you since I first saw you in this house." Now, he has confessed his love. However, this is not requited and Estella rejects it. However, we can see here that Pip's love is really genuine through firstly this simple sentence. Remember, a simple sentence is a sentence with one clause, a subject, verb, and object, and it's very brief. So what this simple sentence is conveying is the genuine nature of Pip's love for Estella. However, he is misguided. Also, separately, you want to look at the repetition of the idea of love, so love and loved, and the pronoun you, where we can see, and of course Pip repeats this when he's talking to Estella, we can see that he's really enamored and enraptured by her, which makes the fact that his love is unrequited all the more tragic. So that's it when it comes to the key quotations to bear in mind with Pip's character. There are lots of other quotations you can use, so feel free to also add to that. However, these are the main quotations which I would suggest cut across lots of the themes and even lots of the character relationships when you're looking specifically at Pip's character as the protagonist of the story. So thanks so much for listening.